Hi, today I'm going to walk you through using the new Simple Mode in the Rush Hour Unreal Vehicle Toolkit in Blender. I'm going to be preparing this vehicle from CG Trader, but you can use any vehicle you want. First, what you need to do is grab the latest release of the Rush Hour Unreal Vehicle Toolkit. You can get that from the GitHub page and go to releases, and we want to get at least version 1.3 or newer. So if you click on that, scroll down and click download source code. And we can see that's downloaded. So we can see that's just in downloads. Now open up Blender. From here, go up to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, Install, and make sure you go to Downloads and choose the one you just downloaded. Press Install Add-on, and then you can see it's appeared here, and you just want to check that to make sure it's on. So now that the plugin's enabled, we're going to clear the scene and import the new vehicle. So just select everything and press delete on your keyboard and go up to File, Import, and I've downloaded the OBJ version of the scene, so I'll click this one. So go to where you've downloaded it and click the OBJ file, but make sure in the options on the right you go split by group. This will make sure it doesn't come in as just one big object and we'll be able to work with it a bit easier. As you can see on the right hand side, we've got all of these meshes, and if we look to the left, we've got this big black mass with some outlines. So that means it's coming too large, so we're going to scale this down. Move your cursor to the top right to make sure we've got plenty of room to move our mouse, and tap S on your keyboard, and we'll drag that in, and it's coming down in size. We'll left click and we'll do that one more time. That's looking about right. So now we need to rotate it. Make sure you come up here and go to Snap and turn on Effect Rotation. We need to make sure that it's level, and also that it faces down the x-axis. So come across to rotate and click on the red line and drag that round, and see it snaps to these degree increments. And that looks right. It's sitting on the ground, which is good. And now in the top right, you can see that we've got these little direction indicators. So we want to rotate around so the x is facing away from us and the y is pointing to the left. So now we can click on the blue part of this line and do the same thing, rotate this around until the car is facing down that direction. And that looks nice and straight, so that's what we want. Now we'll do one more sanity check on this. We're going to press 1 on our number pad, and we can see we've got a side-on view. And we'll go to the measuring tape, and we'll just drag from the rear of the car to the front of the car. We can see that's 7.6 meters long. That's way too long. We probably want this to be around about 4.5 meters. If we draw a little measuring tape from here, about there on the mouse and there across. So if we go somewhere around there, and we'll use that as a guide as we resize the vehicle. So press S and scale in, and that looks about right. If you're unsure how big to make your car, the sedan templates in Rush Hour assume that it's going to be around 4 to 5 meters long. And if you want a little bit more information, go Google a similar car to what you're looking for and look for the specifications, and you're looking for the outside dimensions of the car, and use realistic values. So in this case, you might look up an existing supercar and look for its outside dimension, its body length. But that's good enough for now. So let's go back to the select box and we'll start preparing the next part of the vehicle. To bring up the Rush Hour menu, press N on your keyboard. That's N for November. And we can see it brings up this menu system on the right. And we want to click Rush Hour Unreal Vehicle. And here we can see we've got the Simple tab and the Advanced tab. For now, we'll just focus on the Simple tab. The first thing we need to do is hit Prepare Scene. We can see that that snapped the camera to the vehicle. And also, if we shrink the default collection, we can see that all these new vehicle collections have been added. This is where the vehicle is going to be added into. You don't need to worry about this at all, but if you're interested what's happening behind the scenes, this is what's happening. If you press 1 on your number pad, it'll take you to this side view. And what I like to do is I like to select everything on the vehicle like that and press Add to Body. You can see that the number of objects in the collection has gone down, as all of those have been moved to this body collection. If your vehicle has all the body already combined into one mesh, you can just select that single mesh and press Add to Body. But in the case of this vehicle, there's many, many meshes that make up the body, so we need to make sure that we get them all. So one trick I like to do for that is if you come over to the right-hand side again and press the eyeball or hide in viewport next to the vehicle collection, we can see what we've already sorted and what we haven't. So now I can just select what already hasn't been added and press Add to Body. And now we can see that all of that is now in the vehicle collection. So if we pan around the car now, I like to choose a view like this, but if you toggle the vehicle back on, just make sure that the vehicle is facing the top of the screen. And now we can work through sorting out the wheels. On this tab, just drag it out to make sure we can read it all. And what we'll do is the same process. We're going to select the front left wheel and press add to FL wheel. Select the front right wheel, add to FR wheel. Rear right, RR, rear left, RL. That's it. By hiding that collection, we can make sure that everything has been sorted in and no meshes have been missed. And now we can turn the vehicle back on. Next thing we need to do is just make sure we save the scene. I'm going to save it right next to where the downloaded model was, and we'll just call this generic supercar. If you don't have it saved, this next step won't work, so do make sure you save it and make sure you remember where you save it. Now press export prepped vehicle and give it some time to process. And once the editor is responsive again, we can pan around the car. We know it's finished. So this is the blend file that I saved before. And you can see now that we've got this export underscore generic supercar folder. This is where it's exported out everything we need for Unreal. If you double click that, you can see that it's got all these FBX files. That's the actual mesh data that Unreal will use. And it's also got this JSON file, which the importer will read to set up the vehicle correctly. If you're interested, you can open this in a text editor and you can see that it's got the body dimensions, the wheel radiuses, and so on. You don't need to worry about this too much, but if you're interested, that's what's happened. So across to Unreal now, we just want to make sure that we do have Rush Hour enabled. So go up to Edit, Plugins, and search for Rush, and just make sure that's ticked. If it's not, check it, and a little message will come up down in the bottom right asking you to restart the editor. Go ahead and do that. So now the editor's reloaded and Rush Hour is enabled, we need to open the vehicle importer. In your content browser, in this settings button, click that and make sure show engine content and show plugin content are enabled. And then come over to the left over here and expand out engine and plugins. And we're going to scroll down until we see Rush Hour. So Rush Hour is here. We're going to expand this out so we can read it better. And click on Rush Hour Vehicle Animator Content and open up Blueprints folder. And we can see we've got this EUW vehicle importer. You want to right click that and go run editor utility widget. So this is the import menu. Because we use simple mode, we didn't separate out any translucent materials or meshes. So that means we can't use Nanite because Nanite doesn't support translucent materials. So we're just going to uncheck use Nanite for this. And we're going to choose the vehicle type that most closely matches. So in this case, I probably want to make it a sedan rear wheel drive. All the rest of the defaults should be fine. So then we'll just press import and it will come up asking us to find the vehicle manifest file. So if you go to where you saved your blend file and go to that export folder that appeared, we want to select that JSON file I showed you earlier. Click that and press open and give the importer a little bit of time to process. So that imported, we'll close this message log and we'll close the importer. One thing I like to do is just quickly check the output log. If you go up to the window menu and go to output log, you can see the log for Unreal here. So if we scroll all the way to the end, we can see that there's a lot of messages in here. We're just looking for anything red, but here it looks fine. So there wasn't any problems with it. So we can just close that now. And now we'll scroll up and we can go to our normal content folder and go to imported vehicles. And we can see that there's this generic supercar folder. Open that and it's set up all the blueprints necessary. The one thing it can't do is set up the physics asset. So we're going to open this fizz underscore generic supercar, double click that. And it's got a few different capsules here, which you can see don't quite line up with the car. So click on body and over here on the primitive type, change that to single convex hull and press regenerate bodies. That's created an approximate mesh, which relatively closely matches the car. And then on the wheels, we can click all of those and change those primitive types to sphere and hit regenerate bodies. You can see those now more closely match the vehicle. Click the little save button and close that. On import, this will have created basic materials named the same as the ones in Blender. If your Blender material names match names already in your project, it will assign the existing materials. Otherwise, it's just going to create some basic materials, which you can go into the materials folder and view. Feel free to modify them or replace them, or even if you come back to your BP generic supercar and press open full blueprint editor, you can come down to each of the meshes down here, say SM body, and you can replace these with any materials that you like. But I'm going to be happy with just these materials as they are. So that vehicle is now drivable. You can use the manual driving mode and drive that vehicle manually, or we can let Rush Hour drive it. To let Rush Hour drive it, we need to let Rush Hour train it. So we're going to go back to the Rush Hour folder, come all the way down to Rush Hour Vehicle Animator Content and Blueprints again, and we're going to right-click this EU training menu. Right-click Run Editor Utility Widget, and we can see that this new folder popped up, this new window popped up. I'm going to pop it out so we can see it a bit better. So hit Load Training Environment, and this will load the map that we do all the training on, and we'll shrink that content browser down. And we want to choose the new vehicle that we just imported. So in this case, it's BP Generic Supercar, and just hit Begin Training. As you can see, the vehicle is now driving. Give that 12, 13 minutes to train, and then Rush Hour will be able to drive this vehicle properly. And that's it. You've now imported a new vehicle straight from Blender to Unreal. If you have any difficulties or issues, feel free to reach out via email or the Discord server.